As the federal government has suspended a charter and aircraft maintenance firm, Executive Jet Services, for flying musician Aziz Fashola, also known as Naira Marley, to Abuja to attend a concert. The Minister of Aviation, Hadi Sirika, said this during the Presidential Task Force briefing in Abuja. Sirika said the aircraft, which conveyed the musician, was supposed to fly an appeal court judge, Justice Adefokpe Okogie, from Lagos to Abuja. Meanwhile, the Executive Jet Service has issued a statement that the airline was deceived and they assumed the flight was being booked by Minister of Works and Housing, Babatunde Fashola, who coincidentally shares the name with Naira Marley's younger brother, who bears same name with the minister, Babatunde Fashola, who was included in the crew. To speak more on this is Wole Shadari, the aviation editor with Daily Telegraph. Good afternoon, Mr. Shadari.
Good afternoon. Thank you for having me.
Well, thank you for joining us. What do you have to say over the excuse given by the airliner as regards this whole situation with Naira Marley?
Thank you very much. I think, first and foremost, it was irresponsible of the airline to have claimed that they do not know the difference between Mr. Babatunde Fashola, the minister of the minister in this government, and a musician called Naira Marley. I think the airline is just economical with the truth, in the sense that that was not the only illegal operation it has carried out in the last 2 months. Because if you also look at it, the Flairjet saga that happened, it was discovered that this same operator had a hand in it. Not only that, only a few days ago, he also had a hand in another one that happened, which the government was trying to sort out before this very one. It is a good thing to give approvals, but we think that the Ministry of Aviation, the aviation people, are not doing enough to monitor these approvals given, because these airlines will always cut corners. But if you don't do what you are supposed to do as a regulator, as a policeman, definitely they will want to cut corner. And that is very, very dangerous to the sovereignty of Nigeria, because in a situation where you give false information to the control tower and even to the supervising authority, it shows that you are putting the lives of everybody in danger in Nigeria. What of if those people they picked were criminals, if those people they picked were Boko Haram members, if those people they picked had sinister motive for this country? Are we just going to sit down and say they mistook Naira Marley for Mr. Babatunde Fashola? You can't just explain it. But thank God, the airline has apologized to the minister, but it goes beyond apology. What they need to do, and they have done it rightly, by sanctioning the airline, by sanctioning the pilot, so that this will serve as a deterrent to others who want to endanger the lives of everybody.
Please stay on Naira Marley, and the question will be, has he breached the lockdown guidelines, by the way?
Yes, he has done that severally, not just last week or this week. He has done that. You remember the Funke Akindele saga, which he was at the party, and somehow, we don't know how he gets away with all these problems, because if you recall vividly, Funke Akindele was jailed for breaching the protocol, the COVID-19 protocol, and was sentenced accordingly. But what happened? Naira Marley was left off the hook, and you begin to wonder what type of system we run in this country, where this man, or this boy, let me put it that way, has consistently violated the COVID-19 protocol, and one that has even gone on Instagram, on Twitter, to say COVID-19 is just a scam. You can understand the type of person we are dealing with, and somebody that could, in connivance with the executive jet, because I need to call their names now, because it's always already in the public domain, who connive or allegedly connive to carry out that type of operation. The airline is liable. Likewise, the captain that did that operation, very liable, because what they did was to deceive everybody that they were going to pick a judge, which eventually they didn't do, and which they got approval for, which is legitimate, because even in COVID-19, there are humanitarian services, there are essential services that are allowed for a category of person, depending if the government needs them to do one or two things. Mm-hmm. So they duly got an approval given by the Minister of Aviation, Hadi Surika. But what did they do with this approval? They went behind the minister, or they went behind the government to carry out this illegal operation. Right, it's condemnable. Is really, really condemnable.
Right. Now, what more stiffer measures should Aviation Ministry make so that this is not setting a precedent, you know, for others?
Yes. If you recall vividly, the Flexjet saga that happened last month, everybody criticized the action of that airline. And but what do we have in our statute book? The penalty for one count offense is 500,000 naira. Yeah. So it is so small, and you can't go beyond what is in the books to begin to mete out stiffer punishment. You have to follow the books. So what we need to do is to ensure that we look at our laws to update them as time goes on, to meet up with the challenges of now, and not something we just keep on the shelf for 30 years. We'll still be operating laws and statutes that are outdated. From time to time, we need to look at them. We need to look at how to upgrade them, how to make them meet with the challenges of today. So you can't go beyond that. But what the government can do is to ensure that somehow, because it's a serial violator, executive judge is a serial violator in this, in what has happened. So they need to go beyond. Already they've suspended the airline indefinitely. Because let me also tell you what they normally do. When they get approval for just one person or two people, they wait and see if they could get more people and collect money from them and add to the ones that have approvers already. So what they do purely is commercial operation at the time. All other airlines are trying to sacrifice. They are trying to shut down their operation in line with federal government's directive on COVID-19. So if you have gone to do commercial operation, it means that you have cheated the system. Not only have you cheated the system, you have also endangered the lives of not only people from COVID, but also the security of this country by carrying out that operation, which is totally illegal.
All right. Thank you so very much, Shadary Wole, for your time and for bringing different perspective and aspects to the subject matter.
Thank you very much.
All right.